Hello and welcome to this guide about how to use Carmilla in Mobile Legends. Carmilla is a support hero that steals defense and HP from enemies. A few pros of Carmilla is that she's very strong in teamfights because of her passive and ultimate. She has high movement speed when using skill 2. She can recover HP with her first skill quite well and has decent CC skills. Some cons of Carmilla is that she's weak against long range heroes and mana can drain quite fast. Let's start with her passive. Carmilla steals physical and magic defense from enemies. When dealing damage against enemy heroes, she is able to steal 6 to 12 physical and magic defense from every hero. The stolen defense lasts 5 seconds and can stack up to 5. By casting skill 1, Carmilla deals magic damage to all surrounding enemies for 5 seconds. This slows down the targets by 10% and recovers HP. By using this skill against minions, it only restores 30% of the HP. Skill 2 consists of 2 parts. By casting this skill, Carmilla increases her movement speed by 70%. She can then cast this skill against an enemy hero to deal magic damage and stun the target. The damage and stun time scales with the time it charges up to 1.2 seconds. Lastly, we have her ultimate, which is a very powerful skill in teamfights. She can cast this skill against an enemy hero and this will deal magic damage and slows the target for 5 seconds. The skill also spreads out to 2 other enemies, linking them. When one of the linked heroes receives damage or CC, the other 2 will also receive 70% of the initial damage and CC time. More about how to use her skills and combos can be found in the gameplay plus tips and tricks part of this guide. For emblems, you should pick the tank emblem set with points in physical defense, cooldown reduction and the damage after using basic attack. Choose the following items for a well-balanced build between physical and magic defense, HP and cooldown reduction. As a battle spell, you should use Vengeance to deal damage back against attacking enemies. When playing Carmilla as a tank, you should pick the gold lane to help the marksman farm as efficiently as possible. Buy boots and level up and maximize skill 1 first. When attacking enemies, try to hit them both with skill 1, so you gain more HP back and the passive effect gets activated. That's a very bad start. Beatrix took too much risk. Getting killed this early is a big waste. Always use the minions to heal on when you lost HP. Try to wait as long as possible when stunning an enemy with skill 2. When the bar turns red, you've reached the maximum stun time and damage. When you are attacking enemies, start with skill 2 to increase your movement speed. Then use skill 1 to activate her passive, recover HP and deal damage. When the bar is filled, try to stun the hero that deals the most damage. You can also use Vengeance when you expect the enemies to attack you. This can deal a good amount of damage against the enemy heroes that deal damage against you. Just recall when your HP and mana is low. Her first skill can recover some HP, but sometimes it's faster and safer to just recall. The bushes are the best friend of Carmilla. You should cast skill 2 inside a bush, so the enemy doesn't see you preparing to stun. If you see an opportunity where at least two enemies are close to each other, you can cast your ultimate to link them. After they're linked, it's time to deal damage. Area of effect damage works best because the enemy will receive the damage twice. Don't forget that it's your task to make sure the marksman farms as fast and as efficiently as possible. You should stay low gold, so the roam item will give you gold and the effect of the item gets increased. When it reaches 600, it will add physical and magic attack as well as a bit of attack speed. So once again, skill 2, skill 1 and attack the enemies to activate passive and use the ultimate when you see enemies close to each other. Please give a like to the video if you think any of this information is useful. This small effort would help to grow the channel. With the increased movement speed from skill 2, it's easy to walk towards an enemy to stun it. If you have an ally that deals high damage, this can be a very easy kill. Always stay close to the carry. This way you can protect him and he gets stronger because of the increased damage from the roam item. Carmilla is a very decent hero to play as a tank, since she can steal defense and heal, which makes her quite durable. Which hero would you like to see next? Please tell me in the comment section and I'll try to fulfill the request sooner or later. Like you see, if you do a good job at protecting your carry, the carry can gain a lot of gold and XP to become very powerful. This is the most important task of a tank. Always stay next to allies. Carmilla isn't that strong alone and you want to protect your allies and let them make the kills. By just staying close to them, you provide extra damage from roam item, which helps to kill the enemies. I really hope this guide helped you to become a pro Carmilla player. If you have any questions or just want to say hi, you can use the comment section down below. I really like to read them all and I'll try to reply. Thank you for watching and I'll be seeing you again in the next guide.